Hello everyone, this is your good old neighbor Nick Hicks, Spider-Verse and Frozen 2 fan 2001. Today I'm doing a movie review on the Ben Affleck movie called Air, based on a true event of Michael Jordan's shoes. Michael Jordan! So you guys, it came out the year of 2023. So you guys, I don't want to explain what the plot is because I don't want to give you huge major spoiler, because even I think the Super Mario Bros. Movie is a much better April 5th movie than Air, but I do enjoy this film, by the way. It's an outstanding masterpiece and I highly recommend you watch it. It's on Amazon Prime Video because it makes sense, because this film was made by Warner Brothers and got pushed back to Amazon Studios. So Amazon Studio and Skydance did this film because there was no longer a Warner Brothers film. This is not a Warner Brothers film. This is a Amazon Studio film. So just want to make your mind up. Anyway, guys, no further ado, let's get this review started, shall we? I was so looking forward to this movie because I am a huge fan of Michael Jordan, because Michael Jordan, he's easily one of my favorite basketball player ever, next to LeBron James. Well, honestly, guys, not LeBron James in the Space Jam movie. No, I'm talking about LeBron James and the basketball in real life. And sorry, guys, so after I heard that Matt Davis and Ben Affleck and the actor from Zootopia as Nick Wire and the girl from the Suicide Squad is going to be in this movie, and Chris Tucker is going to be in this movie, and I was like, oh boy, sign me in. Time for us to see a movie directed by Ben Affleck. Yup, this film starring Ben Affleck, and this film directed by Ben Affleck. Yup, Ben Affleck is a fantastic director. Well, honestly guys, not only he was in the DCU as Batman, which he's no longer in the DCU film, but now Ben Affleck is doing his own thing, and now he's a director now, because honestly guys, he's no longer going to direct Batman, the Brave and the Bold, because Ben Affleck said that he cannot take this superhero thing anymore because Josh Whedon ruined his superhero dream, because his superhero dream was really successful, but now Josh Whedon just ruined his superhero dream, and now he don't want to be a superhero. Thanks a lot, Josh Whedon, you bastards. Sorry guys, so after I watched this film at my friend's house, just like was 65, which this film 100 times better than 65. After I watched it, all I gotta say, but this film is an outstanding masterpiece. This is hands down one of my favorite Ben Affleck movie I have ever seen in my life, because I have never seen Argo, which is a 2012 movie starring Ben Affleck, the actor that he was in, Wild Knuckles from Minions of Isaac Gru, which rest in peace to him, by the way. Yeah, he passed away, so let's give him the moment of silence of the passing of the villain from Minions of Isaac Gru actor. Alright, we're good. Anyway, guys, do I have any flaws about this film? Well, I have a tiny flaw about this film because, honestly, guys, I do not like the runtime, because the runtime kind of feel like I'm watching a 3-hour film, because this film didn't feel like I'm watching a 2-hour and 52-minute, yeah. Honestly, guys, this film kind of remind me I'm watching a 3-hour film or a 2-hour film, so, yeah. And so, guys, and that's the only flaws I have. Even this film is a 10 out of 10, but the runtime was kind of reckless, in my opinion. But let's talk about how good this film is. The story is very original because we have never seen a movie about Michael Jordan's shoes because, anyway. And here's the actor that Jimmy Kimmel always trash about, which is none other than Matt Davis. Honestly, guys, Jimmy Kimmel, you gotta come down with Matt Davis, man. Honestly, guys, I already know that's your comedy, but Matt Davis all getting sick of tired of his bad scratching by Jimmy Kimmel. And every single time I keep rewatching Jimmy Kimmel video about that Matt Davis, yeah, he keep trashing him for no reason, which that's his comedy, but still, like, come on, man, just give him a chance. And he was a amazing character, and this is hands down one of my favorite performances I ever seen from Matt Davis. And the actor who was in Zootopia as Nick Wire and Shallow, you're gonna love this movie, because this film starring the same actor that he was in Zootopia as Nick Wire. Yeah, honestly, guys, he's easily one of my second favorite performance I ever seen, because my favorite performance by let me see, Jason Bateman, which is other than him as Nick Wire from Zootopia, and Ben Affleck. I love Ben Affleck. Ben Affleck is a goat. Yeah, Ben Affleck is a fantastic CEO in this film. And honestly, guys, my favorite character of this film, which is other than the girl from the Suicide Squad. Honestly, guys, she was an amazing character. Honestly, guys, she was very amazing as Michael Jordan's mother. And she did a fantastic job with her performance. So let's hope, I am hoping that she will get an Oscar nomination because honestly, she was absolutely missed opportunity that she can have the Oscar nomination. But nope. Oscar's being such a racist crap, and now they don't want to nominate her because she did a fantastic job in The Woman King, which I honestly did not like that title. It's kind of reminded me of The Lion King. So, yeah, she did a fantastic job for The Woman King. She did a fantastic job, but all of a sudden, Oscar don't want to give her a nomination. Such racist. It's even racist than Frozen hating on the Little Mermaid just because Ariel's black. Racist! That is so racist. Honestly, guys, I might give The Little Mermaid 2023 the chance because Rainbow Shutback and Frozen Saint Studio, all those two all was a little racist to The Little Mermaid 2023. So I might give that film a chance, so maybe we'll see. Anyway, let's talk about this film. Anyway, and Chris Tucker, he's easily one of my favorite characters of this film because he was really amazing and hilarious character. I do like Chris Tucker in this film. I do like him. And sum up the character of the film, and this film have no villain. Yep, this film have no villain. Which honestly, guys, I won't mind having no villain in some movie because not every movie had to have a villain, for goodness sakes. So yeah. And honestly, the cinematography look absolutely beautiful because I do love the movie take place in the 80s. So this film takes place in the 80s because they have this 80s TV, the 80s gas station, and a bunch of 80s stuff. And I'm not going to spoil the opening. The opening is the best opening of the Amazon studio. They show Ghostbusters. They show some 80s movies. And they show a bunch of 80s stuff. They show Garfield in the movie. Yep, they show Garfield. At graduation, you have your Garfield. And the ending. I do enjoy the ending of the film. The ending of the film was very emotional, in my opinion. And the acting is so iconic masterpiece. So let's hope the actress from the Suicide Squad will get a Oscar nomination. But if they don't, I'm gonna be done with the Oscar because I'm getting sick and tired the Oscar is being racist to her. I feel bad for her, man. So overall, guys, AO is an outstanding masterpiece with an original story, likable character, amazing cinematography, and the score was really amazing. And honestly, guys, this film is worth it all. Yep, this film has a foul language, so don't wait your kids to watch it. Yeah, do not wait your kids to watch this movie. And yeah, at my friend's house, the couple babies watched this film, and I was like, what? We gotta turn that down because the baby cussed. And now, my friend might say the baby cussed before, and I was like, OMG. OMG, what kind of society we're living in with you, gentlemen. Sorry, guys, and I'm giving L a 10 out of 10. It's an epic, brilliant masterpiece. And I'm giving this brilliant movie a seal of Nick awesomeness. Even I think this film is an outstanding masterpiece, but we all agree that the Super Mario Bros. Movie is a 100 times better April movie, and that is only one of my favorite April movie I have ever seen in my life back in 2023, than L. Honestly, guys, that was my movie review of AO. Tell me what your opinion on this film on the comment section below. And sorry, guys, which movie from April 5th is your favorite? Let me know in the comment. Honestly, guys, for me, I think the Mario movie is my favorite movie out of the May 5th movie. Even I think this film is a masterpiece. But honestly, guys, let's face it. We all agree that the Mario movie is a 100 times better April 5th movie than AO. Honestly, guys, you know why? Because I have Anna Taylor-Joy as Princess Peach. Mwah, I love it. She is such a beauty, and I love her so much. And even Reggie Gaming do love her so much, so I do agree with him. And sorry, guys, if you liked this video, if you want to see more, please, I recommend you be a subscriber, comment on my video, and share the video with your whole family. And sorry, guys, and I don't know what next movie I'm going to watch, maybe tonight. Honestly, guys, I still have the movie on my watch list, so maybe I could just watch The Machine, I think. Yeah, I might do a rant on The Machine. So stay tuned for my rant on The Machine starting the actor from Luke Skywalker. That film's going to be bad. And I'm pretty darn sure that film is going to be the worst film of the year. So let's hope this film will be even worse than Into the Multiverse. Even I think Into the Multiverse is the worst movie of the year. So let's hope The Machine will be the worst movie of the year. Screw the Little Mermaid, I'm not saying that. No, No, I'm saying The Machine would be the worst, because I thought that film was pretty bad, honestly. Oh boy, I'm not looking forward to it, and I might watch it on my phone. There was no way in the monkey that I would watch it on my television. No, no, thank you. I'm just going to watch it on my phone, for goodness sakes. And sorry, guys, and after that, also, guys, maybe I could do a review of the 80s for Brady's. Man, I'm going to get the positive for one. So, you guys, and tomorrow, I'm sorry. And later on, I might do a win on The Machine. And after that, I'll do a review on the Tom Brady movie called The 80 of Brady's, which I might watch it on Paramount Plus pretty soon. So, yeah. And so, you guys, if you like this video, if you want to see more, please, I highly recommend you be a subscriber, comment on that video, and share the video with your whole family. And about Indiana Jones and the Tower of Destiny, yeah, I'm just going to wait until I have Disney Plus, because I don't normally watch Indiana Jones movie in theaters, so I don't normally watch Indiana Jones in theaters, so I hope you guys will understand it. And about the new DreamWorks film, this came out like yesterday, yeah, the digital is coming out on July 18th, so I might buy the digital, the same thing with Across the Spider-Verse and The Flash, so let's hope I have enough money, and then I will buy those three movies for my airplane. So I'm going on vacation on October 9th, for goodness sakes. So, hey guys, I see you next time. And so long, peace, YouTube.